Les Sarkin.
Hi, I'm Alex Arkin.
And welcome to our ongoing series of Fireside Chats. This is where we get together and pass along information to our clients that we think is important for them to know as we're going through this whole tragedy that we're going through in terms of the coronavirus and also the economic situation. So today what we're going to be covering is getting you up to date on just what the markets have been doing, what the economies are doing the last week and a half or so. So we've got a lot of news on that. Not all of it's good news. We're also going to cover one of the main questions that we're getting from clients right now, and that's the question of, you know, now that we're going through this storm, how has that left my retirement? Mm-hmm. You know, am I still on track to still be able to retire in the next year, two or three? Or if I'm already retired, you know, how's that affected in terms of how much can I take out of my investment? So we're going to cover those today. Again, as usual, we're going to be, you know, fairly brief on this. So let's get started with just kind of an update as to where the markets and the economies are.
Well, starting with the economy, we saw unemployment, the rate of unemployment go down slightly just recently, but unfortunately, we don't think that's going to last very long, only because the COVID-19 cases are spiking again. We were just talking today in Texas.
Right.
They're starting to close down restaurants and bars again. So because we're seeing those cases go up, and we're kind of everybody's kind of expecting this to happen anyways.
Right.
You know, everybody kept talking about the second wave.
So if this is something that, and this is, you know, one of our talking points that is that, you know, is this going to spread nationwide, or is this going to be isolated to places like Texas, Florida, and Arizona, which is now seems to be the most cases right now.
Right.
And, you know, if it spreads, then obviously that's going to be a much bigger concern in terms of the unemployment.
Right.
What's interesting, though, is I've had two conversations now. One was with, actually, I won't say their names, but when we're talking, I was asking them, and they're in the medical field, that with these number of cases increasing, you know, how concerned should we be? And it's interesting, the comment I got from both of them, and one is that there's three numbers that people should be really focusing on. One is new hospitalizations, people that are being put on intubators and that are currently on intubators, and deaths.
Mm-hmm.
Because the number of cases is going up mainly because we're exponentially testing a lot more people.
Right.
So you are going to see more people that test positive to it. Also, the other comment that they made that was interesting is that, and this isn't necessarily a bad thing that we're seeing a lot more cases because we are building herd immunity,
right,
which is what, you know, they were saying at the beginning we need to have. So as long as there's a lot of new cases, but it's not leading to hospitalizations or people being put on ventilators or dying.
And hospitals being overrun.
And that's the concern, obviously. Right. Now, Houston, I guess, that is an issue. They're like at 97% capacity.
Right.
So there is a concern.
So it's not always going to be a national problem. It's usually going to be, you know, certain geographic locations
right.
are going to be much worse than others,
right.
You know, like New York City.
Right. But it is something that we're watching very closely because obviously that could affect the mentality of the market.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, so even if there isn't a direct correlation between number of cases and the stock market, the connection between the two is just how people choose to react to it. So if all of a sudden it's like, oh my God, you know, the world's going to end, and so, you know, the stock market goes down, or people are going to look at this more rationally and say, well, yeah, you know, this isn't necessarily a bad thing as long as we're careful,
right.
You know. So.
And it does affect businesses as well directly.
Yeah.
You know, because these bars and restaurants are closing. They went through the first shutdown.
Right.
And they, if they're lucky enough to make it out, now they're going to have to be shutting down again.
Right.
You know, we already saw a lot of businesses go under from the first shutdown.
Right.
They're not going to be able to survive a second one.
Yeah, and I've heard that comment over and over again from smaller businesses. You know, we have one shot of reopening.
Right.
You know, if it doesn't work, then we're probably just going to shut down permanently. So,
right.
Again, that's the risk right now. We're looking at this resurgence now of new cases. So, again, we'll keep you posted in terms of, you know, what effect that potentially is going to have on the economy and also on the stock market.
Well, yeah, and the stock market, at least, you know, for June this month, it's been, you know, a pretty volatile ride. We've definitely seen the volatility pick up quite a bit.
Right.
You know, I think it was around June 8th, we had that big drop in the market.
Right.
This week, at least, it's been bouncing around. It's still down.
We're down 700, I think, on Tuesday.
And right.
Today, as we're taping this, the market's down about 500.
500,
so,
yeah.
Again, we think this is more the shorter term one this week is more a reaction to what's going on with the cases.
COVID cases spiking.
And also, you know, you throw the election in there. You know, you're looking at some of the polls now.
Mm.
You know, the market's, I think, starting to maybe react to, you know, a concern of, you know, which way the election may go.
Right.
So, you know, again, that's something that we're going to be following very, very close as we get closer to November.
Right. So, well, yeah, we'll see, you know, what happens with the stock market, obviously. I mean, we don't think we're out of the woods yet in terms of volatility. We think that at least for the rest of the year, it's going to be like this, bouncing around. And, you know, it's not out of the realm of possibility that we do see, you know, another drop, a sizable drop in the market, depending on what happens.
Well, and frankly, you know, it's probably probable that we're going to see. Now, again, you know, not necessarily a 30% drop, but I mean, to see a pullback from this point, given how fast and how much the market's come back, really for no reason, you know, it'd be kind of normal to see a pullback.
It completely recovered on literally no good news.
That's what I'm saying, is that, I mean, you know, what caused this? So, yeah, we're very skeptical still and just cautious with, you know, our allocations. Anything else on the
that's pretty much it on the economic side and on the market side.
Anything new on the Fed? Anything on interest rates? Pretty stable.
Interest rates are still pretty stable. Fed, I think we covered it last time. Fed said that, you know, they dropped the interest rates to zero and they're going to probably keep them there for the foreseeable future,
until
at least
until
2022. Yeah.
Okay. All right. So the second part then was really a question that we're getting quite frequently now, clients as we're doing reviews. Is just, you know, so now that we've gone and are going through this storm, where has I left my retirement plans?
Right.
And so the easiest way I can answer that is you can kind of divide that into two separate camps. One, people that are already retired, and then people that are nearing retirement. So, and those are two very different scenarios. So if you are already retired, this probably hasn't had that big an impact on you other than maybe your account values. Because, you know, if you're living on Social Security, pensions, things like that, that income wasn't interrupted. You know, you can't get laid off from your Social Security check. So from a cash flow perspective, for most folks that are retired, it really hasn't had an impact. Yeah, maybe you're not happy looking at, you know, my account values are down, but that's something that over time, you know, is going to recover. It's a different story for folks that are still working and were nearing retirement. So if you were a year or two away, you know, so now if you did get laid off, you know, or you took a substantial pay cut, or
your 401k took a sizable hit.
And your 401k took a sizable, you know, now maybe you need to rerun those numbers and say, well, okay, maybe I'm not retiring in 2021 or 2022. Maybe I need to hang in there for another year. Or, you know, if I was planning on retiring, you know, next January 1st, you know, maybe I wait a little bit longer. Now, for some folks, it'll be an option because they still have their jobs. Other folks, unfortunately, if they got laid off, you know, now they're facing, you know, the prospect of saying, okay, I got laid off, I'm probably not going to be able to find a job then, and I was planning on retiring in 2 years, do I now just go ahead and do it now? Well, I mean, you know, the only way you know that is you have to run the numbers,
right.
You know, and in some cases it's going to work out and say, yeah, okay, it really didn't have that big of an impact. In other cases, it might be, you know, yeah, you do have to work another year.
Or the other option we see quite often is, you know, instead of, you know, working, continuing to work full-time for years, they might just work part-time for a few years.
Yeah, and that's a great point, because a lot of times it's a matter of just getting out of the rat race.
Right.
You know, getting out of that high-pressure job, you know, and I don't need to make, you know, $70,000. I only need to really make $12,000, you know, for the next year or two. That might be the compromise, is that just do something part-time.
Because a lot of times when we talk to people, they think it's either all or nothing.
Right.
You work full-time or you retire. Well, there's an option in between.
Yeah, somewhere in between there too. So, again, that's one of those things where, you know, it's a case-by-case situation. And so, you know, as we're doing reviews with clients, you know, that's one of the key things we focus in on, is saying, okay, how did this affect your retirement? You know, the good news is for most folks that are retired, it really hasn't had an impact. I mean, psychologically it has. I mean, we've had to deal with the whole coronavirus scare, you know, in terms of just your overall health of yourself and your loved ones. You throw on top of that, you know, we threw, what, 50 million people on the unemployment ranks in 5 weeks. So psychologically, yeah, there's a lot of damage out there. I mean, there's a lot of folks that are very, very nervous. The good news is for most folks, it really didn't impact their cash flow. So they, that's one less thing they have to worry about. So I don't know, any other, you know, conversations you've had with clients?
Well, other than that, we just try to remind people, you know, people that are in retirement, you know, if they did have, you know, a drop in the account, hopefully not, you know, a big one, we just remind them, you know, it just basically affects the inherited side,
right,
not necessarily their cash flow.
Right. And the other interesting thing, too, is if you look at, and this is, I think, probably for the majority of people, if you look at your January 1st, 2019, where your account balances were and where they are today, even with the substantial drops in the markets, it's probably pretty close, or maybe even higher, depending on how much
positive
income you're taking out. because 2019 was just a fabulous year.
It was a phenomenal year for the market, for the stock market and the bond market.
You know, and so this year, what had happened was we gave back some of those gains of 19. Mm-hmm. You know, so this is very different than 2008, 2009. So again, it's one of those things where you have to really run the numbers. And that's really about all I had to say this week.
Yeah, you too.
So again, we always ask, you know, if you like these updates, share these, you know, send them along, forward them to, you know, friends and relatives, and, you know, they might benefit this as well. If you're not a current client of ours, obviously just give us a call. Again, if you don't feel comfortable running these numbers yourself, we're always here. You can talk to one of us and, you know, we can run the numbers and we'd love to welcome you to the family. So again, checking off for this week, and, you know, as we always say, stay calm,
stay safe,
stay safe. We'll see you next time.